Hey, you! Stop! What do you want from the Republic of Dave?
This is the Republic of Dave. Duh! It's named for President Daddy. But you have to talk to him if you want to stay here. He's the president of the Republic of Dave. Duh! You can ask over at the Museum of Dave if you don't believe me. But you can't just wander around here. You need to go get permission from President Daddy first.
Okay, I'll take you. But President Daddy doesn't always like new people. Okay, follow me. Are you gonna play Republic with us?
You're almost as big as Dave.
Hi there, honey. Have you spoken to Dave?
Hello. Bye.
We have someone new in my republic. I am Dave, President of the Republic of Dave. You will address me as Mr. President, or I will have you executed. Now, are you applying for a citizenship, asylum, or just vacationing in the Republic of Dave? You are? Excellent. It's good to see that the Wasteland has finally recognized the sovereign Republic of Dave. If the people of the Wasteland are generous and respectful, I might deign to annex them. There's an election for the next president. Don't look so surprised. Can't you see this is a republic? Well then, there you go. An election is what separates a president like myself from a monarch like my father. What now? There's a name I haven't heard in a long time. Before the people elected me president, I worked with a mercenary named Mr. Crowley. We were part of an expedition to Fort Constantine. Alive? I always wondered. He was locked in with a bunch of feral ghouls. They won't attack ghouls, you see. Would you consider taking him a personal item, like this key, and just telling him you killed me? Of course it would. I knew that. I was just testing you to see if you would realize it. Here, take the key. It is a gift from the Republic of Dave to the Wasteland. Very well.
I heard that Dave allowed you to stay. Well, welcome, stranger. Just be mindful of the children. Sure, honey, but don't make it too long or Dave will start wondering why we're talking. Dave is a good man. He looks after all the children and makes sure they have plenty to do. He's bought a lot of toys, not that he'd admit it. He has our Shauna teach classes to the younger ones. She's over at the Museum of Dave to the west of the Republic. Not much to say, really. I'm Dave's wife, or first wife, I guess. I've lived here for many years now. Well, yes. Dave and I were married when he was wandering the wasteland, before inheriting the Republic from his father, Tom. After Ralph was born, Dave said that the President of the Republic needed to repopulate the wasteland. So, now we have a second wife. We have plenty of food and water here, and the compound is fairly safe. I'm glad the children can be raised here, away from the wasteland. I'd like to see more trading done with the local caravans, but Dave's afraid their outside influence could weaken the Republic. Sure, honey. Election time is always exciting around here. Only Dave? He's the only person who ever runs. Keep your voice down. I'm not really comfortable talking about it out here. Anything else? Goodbye. Take care of yourself.
Do you need more than that gift? Very well.
Dave says you're okay? Fine. You should talk to Dave, but okay. First wife. Rosie is the second wife, since she's the oldest and not good for anything anymore. That's President Dave to you, Wastelander. Call him by his full name, or we'll shoot you. He takes care of all of us, even that selfish Rosie and her brats. My children will be a lot nicer than hers. All I have to say is Dave is my husband. Mine. Do you understand? I don't care what Rosie has to say about it. Just because Rosie used to be this big leader out in the wasteland, she thinks she's better than me. She even ordered Dave around once. Dave is a great leader. He's going to bring civilization back to the wasteland. One day, they'll say it all started here. Okay. You're safe as long as Dave says so. Get out of my way.
I told you not to talk to me like that.
Or else what? Yeah, thought so.
Keeper of the key.
Hi. President Daddy says the people from outside the Republic are bad.
So, Dave, I run the museum. Oh, yes. Everything here is from Dave's adventures in the wasteland before he founded the Republic. I give a tour every day starting around 2 p.m. You should stop by then. I'd never really thought about that before. Why do you ask? That's all right. I'm used to the children asking funny questions anyway. Yeah. See you.
Howdy, mister. Are you really from the wasteland? Whoa!
Are you really from the Wasteland? Wow!
Yes? What is it? Come on, I don't have all day. Shauna runs the museum, not me. What the hell do you want? All you need to know is that I'm second in command next to Dave, so don't bother me. And don't talk to Rosie or Jessica either. Those are Dave's wives, and they have work they need to do. Yes, he does, and they're both pains in my ass. Always got to keep them in line, or else they get all teary. Dave made me second commander of the Army of Dave, and that means I get a gun. Don't make me have to use it. Dave is in charge. When he's not around, I'm in charge. If you want anything else, go to the Museum of Dave on the left side of the compound. Oh, great. Just don't bother me. I've got stuff to do for Dave.
Outside the Republic are bad.
According to reports from the ever-so-hoity-toity Tenpenny Tower, displaced ghouls have been trying to gain entrance.
What you need? How about a drink? No? Suit yourself. Help yourself, clown shoes. Grab one from the liquor cabinet. I never trust anyone without a drink in their hand. Of course, I never trust one that does either! Sure, didn't I already tell you to? He's fucking dead, that's feral ghoul. What? Fuck me sideways! No, better yet, fuck him! I swear I'll jam a grenade so far up his ass! I got nothing against ghouls, ha! I even had a ghoul party girl once to see what it was like! This is about the key, isn't it? The goddamn key. If you want it, I better see some fucking caps on the table, clown shoes. That dog ain't gonna hunt. You're gonna have to do better than that. Now that's what I'm talking about. You don't even know what's going on, do you, clown shoes? You just bought yourself a motherfucking key. Now take it and get the hell out of here. Don't let the door hit you in the ass, clown shoes. You got your goddamn key, isn't that enough? You...
Aren't you looking fine? What you doing, honey? I don't know how much longer I can do this,
attention to what you're doing.
If I get the chance, I'm going to try and get to Rivet City.
Later.
Hello, sugar.
What do you need? Very well. Is there a problem with what I'm doing? What do you think would be best? I shall...
Please, water. Help me. Please, please help me. I've been drinking this I've been drinking whatever I can find, but I can't do it anymore. Please.
You again? I thought I told you to get lost. Perhaps you fit in around here better than I thought. All right, I'll take your money. But don't press your luck. I got my eye on you. Don't bother Tenpenny or the other residents. If you so much as sneeze in the wrong direction, I'll gut you.
What? That damn Roy Phillips won't take no for an answer. Keep showing up, looking for a handout. He and his kind aren't wanted. End of story. If I were a betting man, I'd place a stack of caps on him trying something violent soon. And that would make Tenpenny nervous. I don't like it when Tenpenny gets nervous. But I can't spare the manpower to go hunt down Roy Phillips and his band of misfits, or I'd gladly end this thing once and for all. You serious? You don't know what a ghoul is? A goddamn disaster waiting to happen, that's what they are. Sure, maybe you can get over the fact that they look like someone took a cheese grater to their face. But it's what you don't see that's the problem. The radiation slowly eats away their brain. Then they go zombie on you. It's better for everyone to kill them before all that, if you ask me. That's a laugh. Roy Phillips can't be reasoned with. Trust me. But go ahead and try and talk some sense into him. It's your funeral. They've holed up in the nearby metro tunnels. They're living with packs of feral ghouls. They've barred the main entrance. Go through the train yard. Good luck, kid. You're gonna need it. Tenpenny is always on time with the money. And we get fairly comfortable digs with side benefits. He owns this building. We get our caps from him. And don't you forget it. I guess we could do a little trading. Here's what I got. Give me a shout if you need anything else. Watch yourself.
I'm on duty. Can't talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly.
I'm off duty. Come back when... what the hell? Let's just get it over with. I'm Dr. Banfield. What do you need? My current theory is that the destructive disease of the ghoul condition will always eventually render him little more than a mindless killer. the proverbial wasteland zombie with a predilection for raw human flesh. They can't be cured. And there's nothing to alleviate the symptoms. All in all, it seems rather sad, really. Well, not exactly. But my colleagues have published papers. I suppose someone ought to verify their findings. Perhaps I'll do that. Who knows? I might even finally get published. I really hope you aren't hurt. He's the landlord, although you hardly ever see him. I had to treat him once for bed sores, if you know what I mean. Wait! Don't tell him I said that. People are healthy here. They eat well and have a strong roof over their head. Tenpenny is very selective about who he allows to live here. The correct genes and living conditions make for a relatively disease-free environment. Clean water is still a concern, of course. But we've got enough chems to keep the radiation sickness at bay. That's why he won't allow those ghouls to live here. Why introduce a weakness into a healthy system? Well, I guess I must confess, I've never examined a ghoul up close. You're right. I shouldn't make assumptions. Try not to break anything important.
I'm on duty. Can't talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly. Hey there. I'm on duty. Can't talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly.
Yes? Those clothes are atrocious. You should stop by my shop, New Urban Apparel, and freshen up that look. Upgrade to fabulous. They were told they can't live here, but those zombies are too stupid to understand. They live in their own filth, squatting in the nearby metro tunnel. Security keeps shooting them, but they keep coming back. You're certainly welcome to try, aren't you? Talk to Chief Gustavo. A very well-dressed gentleman when he bothers to get dressed. He hardly ever leaves his penthouse suite. Only those deserving to live here can afford it. And let me tell you, those who do live in style. And you can thank me for that. I'm the resident guide to all things fabulous. And I'll tell you what isn't ever in style, disgusting ghouls getting their rotting paws all over everything. That's a silly question. What I have against ghouls is that they are ghouls. Bye-bye.
You're new around here. I'm Margaret Primrose. I run the Café Beau Monde. Stop by sometime. Chief Gustavo assures us that he's increased the number of the security team and will kill any zombies on sight. I hope I don't have to find out, though. Everyone loves my cooking. Yes? It's a great place to live. I've always dreamed of giving people fresh meals and a place to relax and enjoy a good conversation or two. Tenpenny gave me a place to do that. I'm greatly indebted to him for that. Lucky? Perhaps I should feel lucky, but really, we've all worked hard to get what we have. I think it's fair to say we deserve to live here. Those ghouls, on the other hand, they think they can just take whatever they want. Well, they have to earn the right to live here. I guess I never thought of it that way. It's probably really hard just living day to day like that. Now I feel a little ashamed. Every day, it's the same thing. The man has no imagination with his meals. But it's his building, so every day I make that damned iguano bit sandwich, no salt, with a peeled pear on the side. Send it up to the penthouse. Have a good one.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
I would surely have perished if it wasn't for Mr. Tenpenny and his tower.
Hello?
Tenpenny Tower is a wonderful place to live, isn't it?
Get some food.
Something delicious.
Welcome to the Federalist Lounge. I'm Shakes. Wet your whistle. I see, sir. Very well. May I pour you a drink? Don't you worry about any such thing, sir. Care to wet your whistle? Care to? He is the right lord and master of Tenpenny Tower. Or at least that's what my files say. Cheers.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
toast. Here's to stupid men and the women who love them. Cheers.
I am Lydia Montenegro. I'm sure you've heard of me and my shop, Boutique Le Chic. No? Obviously, you don't travel in the right circles. I can't talk now. Visit me at the boutique during business hours.
Morning.
Right. Sure thing.
Hi. New here? Pick any table except the one in the corner. That's Mr. Tenpenny's stable. Nobody sits there. Except him, of course. Welcome to Café Beaumonde. Gourmet meals and service with a smile. Very kind of you to say so. Thank you. Bon appetit.
Anthony.
Good to see you.
Yes?
Hey there.
Hey there.
Edgar, have you ever wondered why the only house call Dr. Banfield makes is to that Susan Lancaster's room? How positively shameful.
Yes, dear.
Earth to Edgar. Mr. Wellington, are you there?
What?
Edgar!
I'm on duty, can't talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly.
Hello.
Well, well, what have we here? Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Susan Lancaster. Perhaps we can become better acquainted in the near future.
Me too. Especially rich, fine young men.
Listen, you look like you can handle yourself. You survived out there in the wasteland getting here after all. You ever have to deal with ghouls? Fine, never mind. I thought you were a real man. Turns out you're just a scared little boy. Are you going to do something about the problem or not? I was hoping we could get to know each other better. What was I thinking? Beats living out there in the wasteland, trust me. See, I'm not like these other puffed-up fogies. I earned my way into privilege. I worked to get here. Later then.
Hello. We are safe from the wasteland.
I'm not here for your entertainment.
Thank you. careful for the tower, but the man is a recluse. I wonder what he's hiding.
Oh, I don't know about all that.
Edgar!
Hey!
Pay attention when I'm talking to you!
Starving.
I'm on duty. Can't talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly.
Are the gustiest, the winds are the gustiest, the gates are the rustiest, the pies are the crustiest, the songs the lustiest, the friends the trustiest. Way back home,
back home.
The trees are the sappiest, the days are...
Herbert Dashwood, damn glad to meet you. Call me Daring. Everyone else does. Maybe you've heard the GNR radio play? The Adventures of Herbert Daring Dashwood? That's about me, you know. Based on my, earlier days. I even had a ghoul manservant. Let me ask you, you ever met a ghoul before? Ah, you've already learned some wisdom in your youth. Congratulations. Haven't you ever heard the radio play? The Adventures of Herbert Daring Dashwood? That guy at the radio station put it together a few years ago. He did it in the style of those shows they had before the war. Came out pretty well. And it's all true. Rockopolis, Miss Chase, all of it. Of course, they do portray me as a bit of a chump. Argyle may have saved my hide more than once, but I had my moments. Ah, those were the days. Argyle was my manservant. Ah, but that's really just a fancy word for the guy who saves my sorry skin on a regular occasion. He was a ghoul, you see. Been around since before the war. We met when I stole his girlfriend back in 41. We'd been best friends ever since. We got separated a long time ago and never reunited. If you find Argyle out there somewhere, you be sure and tell me, okay? Some ghouls moved into the nearby metro tunnel. There's a bunch of the so-called feral ghouls in there, but a handful seem the sociable type. I've tried explaining to my fellow tenants that not all ghouls are monsters, but they don't seem to care. The intelligent ones should stay away from our trigger-happy protectors. If there are enough feral ones, though, they could overwhelm security. Aha! An adventurous soul like myself. If I wasn't retired, I might come with you myself. Well, until recently, the only danger you ever faced in this fine establishment was bumping into all the bloated egos floating around. But now there's a group of ghouls nearby. I've tried explaining that they don't all want to eat you, though some do, of course. Problem is, it's hard to tell which is which. Chief Gustavo has initiated a shoot first and ask later policy. If they're smart, they'll stay away. Go get them! Don't even think of breaking into that.
Calls me. Sure I'm crazy.
I would surely have perished if it wasn't for Mr. Tenpenny and his tower.
What?
Sometimes I get the feeling I'm talking to myself.
Hey. I'm Michael Hawthorne. Who are you? And more importantly, should I care? Oh, fine. We'll have to share a drink sometime. I'm always in the Federalist Lounge. There's certainly plenty to drink about. Take those ghouls, for example. Don't suppose you know anything about dealing with their kind, do you? Oh, I see. Well, I've never met one, so I wouldn't know. I just always thought... I guess I really don't know what I thought. We haven't discussed this already? Apparently, there's a pack of zombies living in the tunnels. Gustavo says he has it under control. On the bright side, it's given me another reason to hit the drink. Yeah? Talk to Gustavo. He may wish to employ your assistance. Well, it's a great place to live, if you don't mind ghouls breathing down your neck. Cheers!
Edgar, dear, Miss Montenegro's quite full of herself, isn't she?
How are you?
Bye.
Yes.
How are things?
Useless
splendid.
Man.
Simply splendid. Thanks so much for asking.
Morning.
Morning.
We are safe from the wasteland. Stand in here.
Millicent, have you ever thought of making friends with the other ladies in the tower? Not that I mind your constant company or anything.
Edgar, I do believe you are trying to shake me off. The fire has finally died away, has it, Edgar? You fancy someone else these days, do you?
That's secure for a reason.
Introductions are in order. I am Mrs. Edgar Wellington. You may refer to me as Madam or My Lady Wellington. You're better mannered than your apparent breeding would indicate. It is nice to make your acquaintance. You didn't happen to catch a glimpse of any ghouls on your way in here, did you? I do hope you're not referring to me. I'm certainly a better conversationalist than some stupid ghoul. And I smell better, too. Again with the ghouls! It's all anyone will gossip about. I can't help thinking about them. Doing... things to us. Let's talk about something else. What? Why, I do believe you are being quite rude. Goodbye. I don't suppose there is some... Things haven't been the same since those ghouls showed up. Has everyone on edge? Don't be a stranger.
Edgar Wellington II, have you met my wife, Millicent?
Hold on. Who let you in here?
Very well. As long as security is aware of your presence. Can't be too careful these days. What with these ghouls and all. Gustavo says he has the situation well in order, but I wonder if he's really trying. Don't suppose you ran into any ghouls on your way in here? Then you obviously don't know anything about ghouls. There's a pack of zombies living nearby in some old tunnel. They asked to move in, naturally. They were told to go to hell. Gustavo's hired some additional goons. Seems to be working. Still makes one a bit fidgety, having those loathsome creatures around. I wouldn't even want them as slaves. Well, I just remembered I have something important to do. Goodbye. Yes? Can I... It's the place to live, the only place one finds any modicum of civilization and breeding. Of course those ghouls are trying to move in here. Can you fancy that? Disgusting zombies living in a place like this? Really now? Nice chit-chatting with you.
Morning.
Ah, hello. I would surely have perished if it wasn't for Mr. Tenpenny and his tower.
Morning. I know you.
Good to see you.
Yes?
We are safe from the wasteland in here. We are safe from the wasteland in here.
Mr. Tenpenny isn't taking callers. Hold on there a minute. Oh, all right, I'll let you in, but if Tenpenny hollers because he isn't expecting you, you're dead. Can I help you?
Nice to see you. Carry on. How did you get past the guard? What do you want? Some might say Tenpenny Tower is my crowning achievement, but no. No, no, my dear boy, it is just the beginning. Oh, it's impolite for a gentleman to talk about himself, but I'd hope this magnificent tower would speak volumes. The ghoul? He's dead. Died 20 years ago. Good riddance, too. I hate those shufflers. Who cares? I hired some mercenaries to get me some equipment from Fort Constantine. He was one of them. Of the five, only three survived. You'll have to ask one of them if you want the gory details. So easily? Somehow I'm not surprised. He's alive? I should have known. It's hard to kill those zombies. You've got to shoot him in the head. Whatever he's paying you, I'll double it. A murderer and a thief. I'd sooner die. I love mercenaries. They're so easy to buy. You'll be paid after I know he's dead. And believe me, I'll know. I haven't heard anything about Mr. Crowley recently, so what could you possibly want? What key? Oh, that key. You're a moron. I don't have any of his precious keys. Idiot! Cheerio.
You watch yourself. You cause any...
You got something to say? Really? You? You're welcome to give it a try. But don't come crying to me when you get hurt. They've holed up in the nearby metro tunnels. They're living with packs of feral ghouls. Be careful. Roy seems damn close to turning zombie himself. I suppose you won't be doing this out of the kindness of your heart, hmm? How's 500 bottle caps sound? Payable upon termination of that damn ghoul, Roy Phillips, and all his followers. Well, maybe you're right. It was something I was going to have to do eventually anyway. How about another 200 caps? And here, you can take this rifle and ammo. But you better not screw this up. Roy Phillips and his gang are somewhere in Warrington Station metro tunnels. They've barred the main entrance. Try going through the train yard. Like I tell my men, don't bother reporting in unless it's to tell me you got the job done. It's dark in those tunnels. Shoot first and ask questions later.